Hello everyone, I'm Celsius. Nice to meet you here. Today I would like to talk to you with this, my favorite car, the BMW E39 M5. Well, this is my car. I purchased it 7 years ago and I love this car very, very well. Today I would like to talk to you around the E39 M5 and this car with me, we have many, many stories to share with you. The BMW M5 at this E39 is around the third generation. At very first, the E12 doesn't get the M5. The E12, most powerful, most top level of E12 is M535. The first generation M5 comes with the E28, called E28 M5. Why BMW would like to do such performance medium executive car? Maybe the story have to trace back to the 1970s when BMW got the BMW M1, and people say the M1 was built with BMW and Lamborghini. Actually, I have no idea if it is just a rumor, but well, when the M5 released and BMW found, whoa, such sports car may cost a lot, but it has to do a lot of help to sell the normal model. So BMW would like to get some more performance cars in his product. But well, why the BMW choose the E28 5 Series for the first step, but not the E21 3 Series? Actually, I don't know the real reason, but I guess that if BMW want to build a small sporty car, maybe that would going to be unsteady because E21 is too small. If you got a very big horsepower, maybe it would drive just like 2002 turbo. The 2002 turbo may get a good performance, but not easy at driving and handling. So I guess that's why BMW choose the 5 Series to do the performance model at the very first at E28. When BMW get the E28 M5, people get shocked. Whoa, such executive car could get such performance and handling. And then the normal E28 get very impressive at sales figure. So BMW would like to get this more and more. Later, BMW get the E3 M3 as well as the E35 M5. The E35 M5 gets two different models. Not merely the sedan touring, but also minor change and after minor change. At very first, the E35 M5 got 3.4-liter engine with 350 brake horsepower. Why they get later 3.8 with 340 horsepower? I guess the reason is the Mercedes-Benz 500E. When Mercedes-Benz produced the W124 at first, Mercedes-Benz didn't want to get the performance model. As well as the E28 M5 get so success, Mercedes-Benz would like to get something to fight with that. Well, at that meanwhile, the AMG was still an individual company. The Mercedes-Benz called out for Porsche to do something, help him. But actually, I am not sure what did Porsche do, because I don't know if there is any tuning by Porsche. I just know that W124 was produced in Porsche, but not Mercedes-Benz, because this car couldn't be the same production line as well as the normal W124. The 124 500E got 322 brake horsepower, which is higher than the very first E35 M5. So BMW would like to fight back. So they get to release the 3.8 300 brake horsepower BMW E34 M5, and then they got 5 together till now. I believe everybody knows that BMW 5 Series and Mercedes-Benz E-Class would full model change and minor change together. When 1995, the BMW released the E39 all-new 5 Series, and Mercedes-Benz also released the all-new W210 E-Class at the same time. And when the BMW presented the E39 5 Series, BMW said they would take the performance version M5 3 years later. As well as the Mercedes-Benz also said they will do the same thing after 3 years. That's very interesting. The BMW E39 got 540 with 4.4-liter engine, 286 brake horsepower at first. As well as the Mercedes-Benz W210 got E430 with 279 brake horsepower at very first. And later, when the 1998 BMW released the E39 M5, they got 5,000cc, actually not to 5,000cc, actually the capacity is 4,941cc, but get 400 brake horsepower. Okay, well, when Mercedes-Benz got the W210 E50, they got 340 brake horsepower, and later they got E55 with 360 horsepower. Both of them are fewer than the E39 BMW M5. Okay, BMW wins? Not a must, not maybe. The E39 M5 just got manual transmission, but the Mercedes-Benz E55 got automatic transmission with the touring style, the touring car, as well as the four-door sedan. But the E39 M5 just got the four-door sedan only. That's quite a pity. But when they got to the market, people would like to buy the BMW E39 M5 more than the Mercedes-Benz E55? I'm not sure, because they are different car actually. Consider with the handling, the E35 M5 is much better actually, but consider the operation and the convenience, the automatic E55 is better. Well, that's why there is just a few E39 M5 in Taiwan, but many E55 W210 in Taiwan. And certainly there is another important reason. There is just merely maybe just 7 or less than 10 E35 M5 officially imported by Taiwan BMW company called Pan-German, Fande. Because when the late 1990s, Taiwan here got a very, very strict, very, very high level oil consumption. If you couldn't pass the regulation, you couldn't import such car. The BMW M5, at the very first, they couldn't clear this regulation, so they can't import it officially. That's a very big problem. Actually, when the BMW released E39 at 1995, the Taiwan BMW got a lot of information on its owner's magazine to say, we will present the E39 M5 later. And people was looking forward to that. Oh, when we can get the E39 M5? When the E39 M5 released at 1998 at Paris Motor Show, Taiwan BMW also said, we will import it sooner or later. Please looking forward to it. But later, there's no any information anymore. That's very interesting, because the oil consumption is too high. It couldn't pass the oil consumption regulation. That's very pity. But well, the E55 is easy to pass the oil consumption at that time. So people like to buy the E55 W210 with automatic transmission with the touring sedan. There is just a very few parallel imported E39 M5 as well. According to somebody said, there are just nearly 30 E39 M5 imported to Taiwan at that while. That's very, very few. So the second-hand price now is pretty higher than the W210 E55 AMG. Okay, at the exterior, this car is easily to transform from the normal E39, just like the E39 M3. And especially in Taiwan, here we got domestic-made M5 look front bumper, M5 look back mirror, M5 look back bumper. So if you just buy a normal E39 5 Series, you just purchase something very cheap and you can turn to an M5 look, and nobody thought that it is M5 or not M5. For example, this is the real M5, but many people think this is fake M5 here in Taiwan. That's very interesting. I ever joined to the M5 meeting, Erno meeting, many years ago in Taiwan. When I driving in, the indicator said, please park around the 520 together, because they don't know this car is M5. Actually, it's not surprising to me, because when the people look about this car, they will think it is 520 with M5 look. They will believe it is the real M5. Actually, if you got some information around the E39 M5, you will found that the color is unique for the M5. Actually, around all generation of M5, only E39 got such special color for the main color of the M5. For example, if you thought about E28 M5, E34 M5, the main color is just black, the same as the normal E28 or E34. But E39 got this light blue, they call it Silverstone Metallic. And this color is very interesting because it got the minor change. That means this such light blue got difference before minor change and after minor change. Before minor change, they called Silverstone Metallic. After minor change, they called Bayside Blue. But you couldn't judge what's the difference around these two colors except you get two cars together. And actually, this car it just looks like the Mazda 5. Actually, I got some Mazda 5 paint on this car. For example, this scratch is not made by me, it's made by the former owner. And when I bought this car, it is black right here because they got some scratch. And I asked my paint work to get some paint for me from the Mazda 5, and I got it. And then it is not easy to recognize if I didn't say about that. That's very interesting. And I ever parked my BMW M5 together with the Mazda 5 together. Well, the initial is the same, called M5, and the color the same. That's very interesting. And actually, this car got another very interesting is that the A39 M5 got a minor change for the 2001 model. According to the officially information, the 2001 model should be product after September 2000. But this car, when I say the certification from the BMW, they say this car is 2001 model, but this car is produced at June 2000. Oh, I'm so surprising, because whoa, this car got the Silverstone Metallic, which is before minor change, but you got 2001 model, it is minor change. I'm so surprised. I have no idea why they got such problem. But when I asked the former owner, I got some information about that. I am the third owner of this E39 M5. And according to the former owner said, he is the second owner, and the very first owner is his cousin. And his cousin bought this at the Taiwan BMW showroom. This car was the show car. And I checked the car history. The car got another license plate number at the very first. I think this car is the very first minor change Taiwan BMW test car. So maybe this is special order for Taiwan BMW to make a test for the import of the minor change BMW E39 M5. I guess that, but the real reason, I have no idea actually. If anybody got the car produced before September 2000 with 2001 model, please share with me. I think it's very interesting. And actually, there is a little minor change about the engine room before minor change and after minor change. And this car, my car, got before minor change style with the parts of the minor change. So I have no idea. The color, the engine, the production date are all before minor change, but the model is 2001. I think it's very interesting. Actually, if we talk about the exterior, there's just a few change before minor change and after minor change for the BMW E39 M5. That will be shown at the front lamp and the tail lamp, which is the same as the E39 before minor change and after minor change. But when talk about the grille, if you got the normal E39, you will find that this is the after minor change front grille, which is stronger. But actually, when the very first the BMW E39 presented in 1998, they got such front grille. That means the BMW E39 got the same as the M5 chrome front grille after minor change. Actually, that would be that. So how could we judge a BMW real M5 and a BMW fake M5 of E39 by the exterior? I got some way to judge it, but not 100% precisely. At very first, you can check the back mirror. This back mirror could easily bought in Taiwan with very cheap price. Certainly, it is not original BMW parts. It is Taiwan domestic parts. You can check the lens inside. At the original BMW parts, this lens is very exquisite. But if you bought Taiwan domestic model, you will find that the lens get a little bit different in shape. You can check about that. The second way is about the pipes. The E39 got 4 exhausted pipes, but normal BMW 5 Series just got 2 exhaust pipes. So people would get the 4 pipes looking. So you can check if there, one side the pipe is very clean, one side is very dirty. That could be a fake BMW E39 M5. Others, maybe you have to check the differential, but it is at the platform. That's hard to check. And people will say, no. There are still some difference between the normal BMW E39 M5 and normal BMW E39, as well as the trunk lug, as well as the front fender, as well as the engine hood. Well, that is E60 M5, not E39 M5. So I have to say, it's very easy to get E39 M3 and E36 M3 and E39 M5 look with the normal E36 and E39. So if you want to judge it, the best way is open the engine hood. Okay, let's talk about the engine room about this E39 M5 to make sure this is not the fake E39 M5. Okay, when we talk about the engine hood, please be careful when you close the lid. I will show you how to close it precisely. Okay, if you want to open it, just right here, and we got both hands, right it. Okay. Please be careful about this. It is easy to broken, and the old BMW got the same problem with here. So please take care about that. Okay, when you see this, got precisely later. BMW M Power. Yeah, this is M5 without problem. You couldn't get such dimension from the normal BMW, I think. Okay, this is BMW E39 M5. This engine is not very special. That's why I purchased this car, because it is very easy to maintain, actually. This engine comes from the BMW 540 E39 4.4 and increased to 4.9. So we got many parts shared with the BMW 540, and it's very cheap, such like this one, the oil filter. It just cost me about 400 Taiwan dollars, which is the same as around $15. Very cheap. But they got the same problem with the BMW V8 engine, is that the cooling system is not very well. For example, we got a cooling fan right here, and when we start the engine, the fan will get work, but the wind will just get this way. There's no wind at this way, so it will be more easily to get oil leak right this side. Well, this side we got the wind right here when we start the engine, but there's another big problem. I don't know what BMW think about that. The engine is very hot, right? And we got an ABS, hose just very close to the engine. And this pipe is rubber. It is easily to be broken when the temperature is very high. When it's broken, your brake liquid will leak. And if you get brake lead hit this engine, it will caught on fire. It would get fire. It is very dangerous. So I suggest if you get a BMW E39 V8 engine, please get some protection and change this oil pipe to the metallic. Okay, we got a metallic oil pipe at OEM parts. I will change that later. Okay, and there's still some problem. For example, this gap is easy to broken, so just like this one. It's easy to broken, and you couldn't see the brake liquid right is where below here. It is hard to get this one, but to fix it is very hard, but it is very cheap. I remember that I ever changed one, but the price is very cheap if you want to buy a new one. I remember I bought it with 4,500 Taiwan dollars, which will equally as the $150. That's very cheap. So this car gets share a lot of parts with BMW 540. So I save a lot of money to maintain this E39 M5. That's why I love this car. And okay, let's close this engine hood. And please, when you close it, please close it gently. Okay, right here, and we drop it. Okay, that's it. Or if you drop it too high, this will get broken. Please beware about that. And talk about the wheels, that's very interesting. Here you can see the front wheel got very dirty. I'm sorry, because I didn't clean it up. And well, actually I washed this alloy wheels 2 days ago, and it got brake dust very easily. So it is very big problem to clean it, and I always wash the car by myself. So I have to clean this alloy wheel around 2 days or 3 days. That's very busy. And you can see they got a 10 spoke. Actually, got double five spoke at the design. And such design is very exquisite, but very hard to clean it. That's a big problem. And we got another problem for the tire. At very first, the BMW got 245/40R18 at front, and the rear is 275/35R18. Such dimension is not easy to purchase at Taiwan. So when I buy this car, the former owner got 235/40R18 at front and 265/35R18 at rear. It's a little bit easier to buy it, but both of those dimensions are very expensive. I couldn't drive this car for daily use, so I couldn't afford if I buy an all new such wheel, such tires at every time. I always purchase the second-hand one, but it is not easy to find one actually. People may ask why I didn't take this car for daily use. That's many reasons. At very first, this car just got the manual transmission. There's no automatic E39 M5 as well. And the clutch is very, very heavy. I couldn't afford to drive it daily use. For example, my garage got a little bit slope. When I have to back or get out of my garage, I have to back and forth for twice. If I get the third time, I will get problem with my left leg. That's very, very heavy. I think the BMW would like to make you to get a teeny switch so they get so heavy clutch. How heavy about that? Let's make a little bit test and you will know that. Okay, this is clutch. If I push it right here, no, I can't. I have to take it right here and it will get down. It's very heavy. And this it is original. I didn't change the setup about this clutch. Let me show you again. I have to take it and get it down. Oh, come on. It is too heavy. And another reason is that the capacity is very big. Here in Taiwan, we have to pay the tax through the capacity every year. This car got 4.9, so I have to pay close 60,000 Taiwan dollars per year if I want to drive it daily, which will equal as $2,000 per year. That's very expensive, and the oil consumption is not very, very kindly. I don't like to drive very fast. I just drive gently, but according to my record, the oil consumption will be around 1 liter for 10 kilometers. Maybe 1 liter for 12 kilometers at high speed. But if I get the city and maybe just drop to 6 or 8, that's a big oil consumption. And you got to get a higher level of the gasoline. You can't get the regular or the basic gasoline for this engine. And the maintenance is still another problem. For your budget, this 5000 cc have to take 9 bottles of the 10W60 oil. That's expensive. Although it got a very cheap oil filter, but not very cheap at the oil. So I can't drive it daily use. I just drive it for the holiday joy toys. So this is not a recommend if you driving this car for daily use here in Taiwan. But I know a lot of bad friends who get E39 M5 in America and take the daily use. Oh, I'm so jealous actually. Okay, and it is very rare here in Taiwan about E39 M5, and we still got a little bit of friend, but some of them get daily use. Oh, I'm so jealous as well as that. Okay, let's take a look about the interior about this E39 M5. Actually, there are not very different parts between the E39 M5 and normal M5, especially after minor change. The Taiwan BMW get very good equipment at the minor change BMW E39. For example, this M steering wheel is standard equipment at after minor change E39 my Taiwan model. So this is not very special at the E39 here in Taiwan. And we got the M5 sticker right here. And we got a different substance at interior at ceiling right here and right here, a pillar. And we got a different design for the tachometer and speedometer as well. We got the top of the speedometer at 300, People may ask me if I ever drove this one. No, never. Because when we drive to 2050, and we got some limitation, and I didn't break it. And we got chrome at the every gauge, and we got a little bit change right here. It is oil temperature, which will be the oil consumption at a normal BMW E39, as well as that. Okay, here we got the most difference is this gear knob. This gear knob is for BMW E39 M5 exclusively. And we got two set of E39 M5 at interior. This one is for executive, so we got woody trim right here, and we got a very good at leather seat. And there's another way about the interior for the Sportivo. If you got a Sportivo interior, we will get titanium trim level right here, and we got a sporty leather seat right here. They got different style, but actually I have no idea why this car called executive, because there's no some such executive equipment at the back seat. There's nothing very special at the back seat actually. And well, people may think the engine sound of the BMW M3 or M5 got a larger, get bigger than the normal E39 or E36, but actually it is wrong. The engine sound of E39 M5 just the same as the V8 BMW E38, E39, E66. Here we go, let's start the engine. Yep, the engine started. The engine sound is not very big because I didn't change the anything, as well as the exhaust pipe. It is original. And when we hit the gas acceleration gap, the sound is still the same as the normal BMW V8, such like E39 540, just the same as that. But there is a very interesting equipment for this gear knob. When we turn on the light, there is still got a lamp right here, and it is very exquisite. I like this, especially when I'm driving at night. And they got a little bit of temperature. So if you drive at winter, you will get a little bit warm at your hand. I like this one so much. And well, there is something different between the BMW M5 and normal BMW with this. We got cell phone right here. Okay, let's turn off the engine because the oil consumption is too much. And this is my car. If this is not my car, I will keep the engine on and get air conditioned. Okay. This is cell phone for the BMW E39 M5, and it's option for the normal BMW E39. Certainly, you can't dial a number right here because it is 2G. Now we got 5G, and maybe there's no any 4G signal right now. Okay, and I ever saw there is another style of the cell phone at E39 M5, but when we get the cell phone right here, we can't open it. There is no any storage for the inside. That's very pity. And there's not space if you want to store something like cell phone. There's no place to place your cell phone. If you want to place right here, it is not very identical. And it is not identical as well. If you want to place here, please beware of that, because they got a cup holder. And this cup holder is easily to be broken, and it got not very useful actually, and easy to broken. So please don't take this one as well. And here we can see there is some interesting button. Okay, let's turn off the lights. We got the sport. We got a DSC. That means you can turn this up for the sport version. But I don't know if there's much difference because I never put it off. I would like to get a better oil consumption, and I never close the DSC because I am not a professional driver, and I don't suggest if you get to put it off at normal road. If you go to track, you can put it off because it won't be problem to other people. Okay, here we got air condition, and we got audio system, and we got this easily broken dashboard. About this, this is for cassette. If you push it and you will see the cassette entrance right here. But this woody trim is easy to broken. You can see the color is a little bit different, right? Because I changed it one time. And it was broken when I bought it for the former owner. And I got one at the broken car yard, and I take it carefully when I use it. And actually, I'm not suggest if you got the cassette tape right now for this old car, because it is easily to broken. Okay, and here we got 6 SRS airbag, right front, and the A-pillar, and the side. But when BMW gets such 6 airbags, there is no air curtain. It is just a Coulomb style for the head airbag, but not air curtain. Actually, the air curtain for the BMW 5 Series maybe got E60, just got the air curtain. And there's nothing very special else, such like sunroof, some reading light, nothing special between the normal BMW E39 and E39 M5, except the center back mirror. It got very easy to broken. It will get some liquid you can see inside, but not this, but not my car. I'm very lucky. People say it is automatic operation when you driving at night and there is some idiot get the high beam at your back, and this mirror will work automatically. But actually the liquid will be easily broken when you got old, but not for me. That's very lucky, actually. Okay, this is that the front seat. That there's nothing special to introduce at the back seat, except one thing below here. I will show you that. Okay, let's get out and get to the back seat. And before we get in the back seat, I think the BMW knows how to earn the money, because compared to the E34, there are many easy to broke parts at the interior in E39, such like this one. Okay, we got a very exquisite M5 sticker right here, and we got easily to broken at the side, and as well as the door panel is easily to broken at E39. And well, there's an interesting part at the back seat. It's right here. Okay, we got the air conditioner air condition at the back, and we got something right here. It is a little bit space for place some tiny thing, but it is easy to broken. Okay, that's a very big problem. And you can see the carpet, the floor pad at the back is not the original, because the BMW original carpet is also very easy to broken. Okay, I got the original front floor pads at front seat for the BMW original, but not back seat, because it is very, very easy to broken. And there's nothing executive equipment at back seat. Even there's no cup holder. I'm so surprising. If you get the armrest right here, you will see. Oh, there's no any box right here, and there's no any cup holder. Oh, I have no idea. Just got we got a little bit map bag right here, and we got S3 right here. Nothing else. Actually, nothing else. Well, because it is the BMW M5, we got the premium sound system with amplifier at the back. But I don't think the sound system got very, very good, because the bass is well, but not as well as the treble. I think it can be improved, because BMW got option for the sound system for the BMW, maybe 8-cylinder and E39 M5. Here we can see about that. Okay, if you open the trunk, you can see there is something right here. If you get such option, that will be sound system right here, but not this car. I think it's very, very, very pity. And we got amplifier right here, and normally we won't use it, except there is a 6 CD changer right here. But I don't know where to buy the all new CD right now in 2024, actually. Okay, people would say there's no spoiler right here, and there's no M5 bandage. Actually, they are removed by the former owner. I don't know why. Maybe they don't. He don't like to be recognized as well as this is a BMW E5. Maybe about that. That's very interesting. Okay. Actually, I like this BMW E34 M5 very well because it is not easy to recognize. It is a normal BMW E39 or a E39 M5. And another reason is that I like E39 M5 very, very much. Okay, that would let me talk about the story about me with E39 M5. When I saw the very first time when I saw the E39 M5 is at Europe. Around 1990 or 2000, I went a European tourist group with my mother when I was very young. And one day there's a big heavy rain. And when we take the tour bus set out from the hotel, and I saw a light blue, just this color, BMW E39 M5 just parked at the signal before us. And when the signal turned to the green light, that light blue E39 M5 got very high speed at acceleration and soon gone in front of us. Oh, I think, oh, this car is just gorgeous. This car is very handsome. And I like this car so much. But there, we just say, the Taiwan BMW just sold very few E39 M5 in Taiwan. So I never see it when I was young. And later, I get a video game called Need for Speed 4 High Stacks, which is borrowed from my classmate. And I never get back that to him till now, actually. And when I play the video game, I like the car, many of the car inside, but the favorite car is this E39 M5, because this car got 4-door salon and got very good at performance. This car is a very balanced with the performance and the usability. I like this car very, very much. And especially there is a showcase in the Need for Speed 4 High Stacks. I remember that when I was young, I didn't get very well at my English ability. Maybe now my English is not very well. Okay. But I would like to listen about the showcase to describe, to introduce this BMW E39 M5, and I just try to translate every word what he said. They say the introduce of this showcase is very fast. I have to translate words by words what it means, and check the dictionary what it means, and to get known about this car. So I love this car by the Need for Speed 4 High Stacks. And actually, I'm so surprised that when I get the internet in recent years, many people say they love this car because the same reason, because they played the Need for Speed High Stacks 4. Well, just the same as me. So I like this car when I played that video game 20 years ago. But I never thought I would buy one after many years. So I think this is a dream come true. But why I bought this car? Yeah, that's very interesting. At very first, I don't know that I can buy an E39 M5 here in Taiwan because it is very rare. And I don't know even if there is any car left right here in Taiwan. At very first, I would like to buy the E36 M3. Talk about the BMW. I believe every man like the BMW M. I'm the same. Actually, you can see I got the Mercedes-Benz close today, but I like BMW more than Mercedes-Benz actually. I ever bought a lot of Mercedes-Benz, but I sold them out right here now. But I still keep some BMW cars right in my garage, such as this E39 M5. I got E21, E36, E46 as well. So when I bought some BMW, and I was thinking I got to buy a BMW M-Power. So I would like to buy the E39 M3 at first because I like this car so much. That is my favorite M3. But well, when I go to E39 M3 meeting many years ago, I found there's a problem that I like the car. There's not big problem with the E39 M3, but I couldn't get a communication with those owners. They are too young. I don't know how to discuss with them. I don't know how to chat with them. And I think that's not what I want, because I would like to buy a BMW M, but I still like to make friends with that car. So I think maybe I should change my target. At very first, I would like to buy the E34 M5, because I still like E34 very well. But I found that nobody wants to sell E34 M5 in Taiwan. Actually, there are a little bit more E35 M5 more than the E39 M5 in Taiwan. Maybe just we got 80 or 90 E34 M5 imported to Taiwan 30 or 40 years ago. But I don't know why people don't like to sell it. So I think, how about the E39 M5? So I changed my target again, and I found this car just sold at the internet, and I contact the owner. That's a very interesting story that when I contact the owner said, okay, come on, please check this car. Okay, let's make friends. And when I meet the owner, the former owner, he said, oh, come on, let's make a test drive. But I couldn't drive this car at very first, because before I purchased this car, I never drive such big horsepower. Before this car, I just drive 200 brake horsepower car, but that is not a performance car. So I asked the owner to drive it, and I got the passenger seat for a joyride. And suddenly we got some chat when this joyriding. And he said, there are two different kinds of people who want to see my car. The first one is just for kidding. What's for kidding? For example, some people say, oh, you got a very exquisite car at E39. Okay, can I buy this engine? Can I buy this alloy wheel? Can I buy this manual transmission individually? Such guy is just for kidding. And the other kind is just look like me. I like BMW, okay? And we never see the BMW E39 M5, and we like to see the real one. So he said, okay, Mr. Salesier, you can see this car and you can take the pictures, and later you can drive it back to your home, and I will drive it, and the owner will drive it back to his home. Okay, but he was wrong, because I'm not the guy for those two kind of people to look at this BMW E39 M5. I'm the third kind of people. I want to buy it, so I bought it. And that's a very interesting story when I'm buying. After we check this car and I drive back my place in Taipei, and he said, oh, well, okay, when we stop the car, and I say, I'm sorry, mister, I'm not the people that I want kidding you, or I just want to see the E39 M5. I'm here to buy your car right here. And I saw you got a price on the internet, and today I prepared some cash. Okay, that's my style to buy a car. I will prepare the cash. I learned this from a TV show, and the slogan right here, the TV show will say, I got cash, you got cash, let's shake hands. It is an England TV show. And when I buy such expensive car, I will always prepare the money, the cash. I think the cash is very powerful. And I prepare some cash. I said, okay, you got the price right here, and I prepare the cash right here. Please tell me what you want me to add my cash to purchase your car. And the former owner got a little bit shocked. Whoa, this guy is serious. He want to buy this car. But he said, okay, let's get the center line. How about that? I said, good, okay, got it. We got a deal. And after we got a deal, we have to drive to a second-hand car shop to get some contract. And when I drive in this car to the second-hand dealer, the owner got silent. He didn't say anything. Before that, we got many, many good communication. We got a chat about that. We got a shattering around everything. But later, he got silence. I think he feel regret. That's real. I get the correct guess. And because when we finish the contract, that will be evening. The DMV is closing. It's closed. So we got a deal to meet together at the DMV to get this car to be my car. I have to say, if you want to buy a car, a second-hand car in Taiwan, you have to go to the local DMV to get a car check, to get the former owner and the new owner's identification, and to pay some tax, pay some fee, and you can get this car here in Taiwan. It is a little bit different from you in America, okay? And when we met at the DMV next day, the former owner said he didn't sleep overnight because he is very regret to sell this car. He got to the mailbox with some drink and sit at the garage to look at this car whole night. Oh, that's very interesting. He is very shocked that I buy this car. I bought this car. He sold this car. He is shocked. But he had to persuade himself to accept this fact. So he said, Mr. Seltzer, please take good care about this car. I hope you can keep your words. And I said, no problem, because I was a blogger. I own a blog on the internet till now. I said, I will take good care about this E39 M5, and I will make the diary at my blog. If I got anything to repair, any maintenance, and I will show you at the blog. Now, please do not care about that. And actually, I got a good friendship with the former owner till now. That's very interesting. And I have to say, this car got many, many stories with me and improved my level later. Before this car, I never bought such performance car before. And when I bought this car, I know how to drive such performance car as well. And this car, it is the top of the BMW. When I go to the BMW car meeting, I'm the king. But I don't think it is satisfied to me. I would like to drive this car with the Porsche, with the Ferrari, with the Lamborghini. Certainly, the BMW M5 would be a kid in front of those supercars. But I got a ticket to get together with those supercars, and I can make some friends with those supercars owner. So I improved my relationship. I can contact such people which I couldn't contact them at my daily life. So this car got very many improvements for me, and I am growing with this car. And actually, because this car is very rare here in Taiwan, so the second-hand value is raising now, and I still keep this is my to buying this car. It cost me many big money actually, but when I sold this car, the money will back and with some interest. That's very interesting. So I like this car very much, and I own this car around 7 years. Maybe someday I will sell it, but I would like to buy another car such like this car, which is performance car, which can make me to get some friends with those top level of the people, and I can get a little improve myself for another level at the next car. I hope I can get this dream come true. Okay, this is today's video. I will talk to you with this BMW E39 M5 and me with this car. We got a lot of story to share with you. If you like this car as well, please show your comment about this video to show me why you like this BMW E39 M5. Certainly, if you got the same reason, that I will be very happy. Okay, I'm Seltzer. Thanks for your watching this video, and hope to see you again with another interesting car. See you again. Bye bye.